Come, let us worship the one who came, comes, and will come again. Come, Emmanuel, and be born in us this night. Let us stand and sing, Joy to the World.
Let every Will you join me in our opening prayer? Oh God, our Father, you have brought us again to the glad season when we celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that his Spirit may be born anew in our hearts this night, and that we may joyfully welcome him to reign over us. Open our ears that we may hear again the angelic chorus of old. Open our lips that we too may sing with uplifted hearts. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
This night we hear again the sacred story and sing the songs of Christmas, songs of anticipation, availability, announcement, and acknowledgement. The angels carried the message, a great message of great joy. A child would be born in humble circumstances, but in great power and glory. A child who would be the Prince of Peace, the Savior of the world. We are quick to share with others the great Christmas gifts we found under the tree. So let us be just as quick to share the good news of the greatest gift ever received, Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus. As we light the Christmas candle this evening, we welcome the birth of Jesus the Christ, who came, who comes, and who will come again. Let us pray. Come, Lord Jesus, into our world and into our lives. By your life, bring us new life. Be born in us today. Amen.
Will you join me for a Christmas affirmation of faith? I believe that Jesus Christ was born and that the world can never be the same. I believe that in his spirit, by his power, God shall give us the victory over sin and death. I believe the Lord will give us great joy as we walk in the ways of service. I believe the Lord will give us great hope as we walk in the steps of obedience. I believe the Lord will give us great peace as we walk in the steps of sacrifice and accept Christ's work and redemption. Let there be peace on earth and goodwill toward all. Amen. Friends, I offer you these words of invitation. Let us hear anew the age-old Christmas story as recounted in scripture and song. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to a house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 16. And in the same region, there were some shepherds staying out in the fields and keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terribly frightened. And the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which shall be for all the people. For today in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to the God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." And it came about when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds began saying to one another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem then, and let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came in haste and found their way to Mary and Joseph, and the baby as he lay in the manger.
The shepherds came to see the baby, stood by his mother's side. He laid the Savior inside the manger. Oh, what a glorious night. Oh, what a glorious night. I hear the angels singing, "Hallelujah, let the earth
Jesus Christ is born.
The shepherds wondered they could hide him. Told everyone inside. All were amazed when they heard how God came down on that glorious night. God came down on this glorious night. I hear the angels singing. Hallelujah, let the earth. A star shining in the sky. Below in Bethlehem, the King is sleeping. Oh, what a glorious night. Oh, what a glorious night.
Matthew chapter 2, verse 1 through 2 and 7 through 11. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? He saw a star when it rose and have come to worship him." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way. And the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Our next hymn is 240. Let us sing "Hark the Herald Angels Sing."
Glory to the new born King.
The songs of Christmas. Zechariah's song anticipating the birth of the Messiah as he and Elizabeth awaited the birth of their own son. Mary's song expressing an availability to serve as the mother of the one who would come to save his people from their sins. Simeon's song acknowledging that this one coming was the answer to the need of Israel and all, comfort and consolation, the healing of humanity from the ravages of sin. Tonight, as we celebrate the birth long ago of Jesus, Son of God and Savior of the world, we hear yet one more song, the very song of heaven sung by the angels, the heavenly host. While we often imagine that night being quiet and still, some have reminded us that it was probably not a very silent night. The world was abuzz, the noise of throngs gathered under the command of a Roman census, the noise of animals crowded into a warm space, the noise of childbirth, a mother's groans, and a baby's shrill cry. That's probably why it took a choir of angels to make the announcement. During his life, Jesus experienced and spoke of angels. When he was tempted in the wilderness, angels ministered to him. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus said that he could call forth a legion of angels if needed. Angels were there from the beginning. Gabriel tells the old priest Zechariah that his childless wife Elizabeth will conceive and give birth to the forerunner of the Messiah. 6 months later, he appears to a young woman named Mary in the obscure village of Nazareth. He informs her that she has been chosen for the role of giving birth to the promised Messiah. He also made a visit to her betrothed, Joseph, and assured him of Mary's purity and the miracle that she carried in her womb. These angels were messengers, carrying forth the purposes of God, heralds of God's word. But these angels were more than just announcers. They were interrupters. These angels don't gently say, "Excuse me." It's more like, "Hey, stop what you're doing. God's got something to say, and you need to pay attention and hear this." The angel said to Mary, "Hey, God's going to interrupt your young life and your plans and your dreams with this word, the word. You're going to carry the word of God." The angel said to Joseph, "Hey, better pay attention. God's going to interrupt your well-designed life plans and your understanding of righteousness with this word. The word in Mary needs your care and your protection." Then to the shepherds on that evening as they stood watch over their flocks, "Hey, awake and listen. The Savior is born. For this is great news for you and the whole world. The Word has become flesh and lives among you for your salvation." We just sang the hymn Charles Wesley wrote in 1730 when he was just 32 years old. "Hark, the herald angels sing." Hark. That's a nice way of saying, "Hey, better stop for a moment and pay attention. This news is life-changing and schedule-changing and focus-changing. Hark! This news is going to turn your world upside down." And the angels said to the shepherd, "Hark! I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people." Good news, great joy. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord. And suddenly a great company of the heavenly host, a choir to beat all choirs, appeared and sang, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all upon whom his favor rests. This song, the song of the angels, rises first upward and then outward. Glory to God in the highest upward. The first direction is towards God in praise and gratitude. This baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger, this is God in the flesh come here, leaving the riches of heaven and entering the poverty of the flesh. This child, this gift, reveals the nature of the giver. God, who is slow to anger and abounding in mercy. God, whose heart is love. There's a story of a great violinist who acquired a priceless Stradivarius violin. All the press releases for his concert focused on the quality and the fame of the violin. The concert began and the music was glorious. Suddenly, the great violinist stopped playing, threw the violin on the stage, and crushed it under his foot. The crowd was stunned. The artist then took up another violin and declared that it was the renowned Stradivarius. When he started playing again, the crowd realized that while they had focused on the instrument, they should have been focused on the touch of the master's hand. Before we notice the gift, the angel reminds us to focus on the gift giver. Glory to God in the highest. Then we turn our eyes outward on the significance of the gift. To those on earth, upon those on whom his favor rests, peace. Jesus came to bring peace for us. Peace with God. Forgiveness and mercy, because we've lived in rebellion against God's holiness and truth. Peace within. Freedom and rest from the law. No longer must we pursue earning God's favor. It is a gift of grace given. Peace among us. Reconciliation and fellowship. Relationships transformed from greed and violence and position and power to unity by the Spirit. Tonight, we sing with the angels the upward and outward song, glory to God in the highest, and for all who open themselves in faith, peace on earth, anticipation, availability, acknowledgement, announcement. The angels and all creation are singing. So this night, open your hearts to the marvelous gift and sing the songs of Christmas. Amen.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder break a new and glorious morn. Was born, O night divine. and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in a grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Then ever, ever praise we his power and glory evermore proclaim. His
let us sing hymn 239, Silent Night, Holy Night.
Receive this blessing. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the sustaining fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each of you this day and forevermore. Christ has entered the world bringing light to our darkness. Let us carry his light as we go forth.